One typical night in the greater GS, there were four scholars sitting around a table, and they decided they were going to play a little game of five fingers, and their deepest, darkest archaeological secrets were discovered. Danielle, Matt, Neil, and Ashley were sitting around the table, and Danielle made the statement, never have I ever lost anything to a Neanderthal?
Ah, shoot, I guess you got me there.
What?
No way.
All right, guys. All right, I'll tell you. Well, so one time I was down at the IMA shooting some hoops.
Were you by yourself?
My friends were coming. And all of a sudden, I look to my right. Neanderthal shows up.
What?
What? You're kidding me.
Yeah, so this Neanderthal showed up. All of a sudden, he asked me to play. I was breathless. So he's talking to me. He's like, yo, I want to play some hoops. So we play some one-on-one. I thought I was pretty good at basketball, you know. But this Neanderthal was amazing. He straight up dunks on my face. And so after a long, wild, competitive match, we came to the conclusion that he won. And gave me a rock.
Wait, it was just a rock?
Well, actually, it was more than just a rock. It was a Mousterian stone tool.
Oh, used by Neanderthals, huh?
Yeah, it was used by Neanderthals. There's actually many different types. It's pretty interesting.
Was it a multi-purpose?
Actually, it was. There were four different types of it. How did you know that?
After a lengthy discussion about the amazing stone tool, they got back to the game, and Matt asked,
I have never hooked up with an archaeologist.
Oh, shoot.
What? You did?
What?
No way.
Oh, I never thought I'd have to share my wildest night with anyone. Anyway, so I was at this crowded party, and things were going pretty well, just standing by myself, waiting for the man of my dreams to come and approach me. This guy wasn't cutting it. I saw these two lovebirds in the corner. They were really preoccupied with each other. I think he even proposed. That's not the point. Anyway, so out of the corner of my eye, I saw this hunky stud nut. What an intellectual type. He was tall and pale and handsome. So as I was, you know, taking a couple looks over in that direction, I noticed that he looked at me too. I did what I'd never done before. I decided to walk over there and introduce myself. So I introduced myself and we started talking about his book. I asked him what his name was.
Hello! I am Lewis Benford, archaeologist extraordinaire. I'm the leader of the new archaeology movement. I'm reading my book. Oh, I'm so sorry. Your eyes are so beautiful. You made me nervous for a second. In other words,
Mr. Benford!
Yeah, I know. I am quite irresistible, unlike my rival, Bord. Oh, yeah, let me tell you about my research. I work with analyzing Neanderthal tools, and I thought different tools represent different functions. Therefore, I was interested in cultural systems and adaptations of Neanderthals.
His archaeological success intoxicated me. I couldn't help being drawn in. Then he asked me to dance. And well, let's just say that the night got even better from there.
Then they all went back to the fingers game. They were all down a few fingers. But then Matt said,
I've never kicked it with a mummy.
Ah, shoot, man.
Wait. You've kicked it with a mummy?
Once.
Tell us about it.
Alright, so this one time.
Okay, so it was my fall quarter freshman year, and I was trying to find my classes. I was wandering around the basement of Kane Hall a little bit lost, and I just saw the most interesting door that I'd ever seen. And all of a sudden, I knew I couldn't go to class without seeing what was inside. I pulled out my trusty stone tool. Oh, the one that you got from that Neanderthal, Matt.
Yeah.
And I decided to pick the lock. So I opened the door, and lo and behold, there was a flippin' mummy inside. I was just so intrigued, and all of a sudden, it started to wake up. I just freaked out. I started running, and it was chasing me down the halls. It was just up and down the flights of stairs, even out a window. I did not know what to do. I thought I'd made it, but the mummy eventually caught me. He was gonna kill me, and so we came to the truce that if I could beat him in ping pong, he would let me live. So there we were playing our game of ping pong. He was surprisingly good for a mummy who'd never held a paddle before, but eventually his slow reflexes got the best of him. I won the game. In the end, it was a truce, and we decided to celebrate by him teaching me his ancient mummy tradition of shotgunning sodas.
That's awesome.
Wait, you guys, isn't this weird that we've all had these just crazy coincidences for stories?
Yeah, I know, like, how have we all just done this wild stuff?
Hello?
Hey, you guys, we're having an Illuminati meeting. I think you understand, so you need to leave.
Illuminati.
After their long study break of doing this crazy game, they all went back to their homework. The end. Just a city boy, born and raised in South
Detroit. He took the midnight train.
Hate on it.